Hey, Ockert. My name is Chris Grenier, and I work with Wayne Motley, and I've actually done a lot of work with Walter Jackson as well, too. But I did see the email that Wayne sent you a couple of days ago, and I know it was a little bit lengthy, but it did go into great detail in terms of who we are, what we do, and how we'll be able to help you, and why Walter pointed you in our direction. But given the fact that Wayne is kind of the voice of the radio show, and I guess you could say that I'm the face of the TV show, I'm going to take a couple of minutes here and explain to you a little bit further about what we do, who we are, and how we can help you. So we've dealt with Walter actually now for quite a few years. And fortunately, he has a fantastic portfolio. And with what the market's doing here in Orlando, pretty much 99.9% of our investors are doing fantastic right now from a capital appreciation point of view as well as a cash flow point of view. So what really makes us unique is our ability to find and source bank foreclosure properties directly from what's called the asset management companies. Now, 5 or 6 years ago, the market was 100% different than what it is right now in Orlando. You would essentially be able to drive down neighborhoods in Orlando, Kissimmee, all of Central Florida, and basically point out any house that you wanted that was in foreclosure. You could easily tell which ones were in foreclosure by looking at, you know, the grass was overgrowing, windows might have been broken, you know, very easily identifiable vacant houses. And as a personal investor, you could just simply call a realtor and get that house without any issues. But that was 5 years ago in 2010, and now the market has gone up about 45% since then, but it's still actually significantly below its peak values in 2007. So what has changed really since then? Basically, it's come down to inventory, and the big players have really kind of rose to the top in terms of being able to get that inventory. So right now, if me, you, Wayne, Walter, or one of the thousands of other investors just try to go directly to a bank and say, hey, I want to buy one property, they're probably not going to listen to you. The big players are what's called the asset management companies, who buy both properties from banks, maybe 50, 100, 200 at a time each quarter, and they get not only economies of scale by buying in bulk, but also they really get the first pickings of what is available. Now, they buy everything from $20,000 condos to $2 million mansions, except what we've been able to do over the past few years of working very closely with a few of them is identify ones that really make the best sense for cash flow purposes as well as capital appreciation. So everybody and their brother will want to say, hey, I own a beautiful house in Orlando. It is a 4-bedroom, 3-bathroom property, 2,000 square feet with a pool and a gated community. And, you know, it's in a great neighborhood. It's gorgeous. Here, take a look at it. And that sounds awesome. Trust me, everybody would love that type of property. However, from an investment point of view, from a cash flow point of view, that's not necessarily the best option that you want to go with. Emotionally, yes. Investment-wise, though, in actual, when it comes down to the figures, no. Because rent and property purchase price does not linearly go together in this market. For example, a $100,000 property is going to rent for approximately $1,000 a month. So that does not mean a $200,000 property is going to rent for $2,000 a month. No, it's going to probably only rent for about $1,200 to $1,500 a month. And as you go higher in price, rent equation and ROI really, really decreases. Just because people who buy houses that are $200,000, $400,000 don't rent them. I'm sorry, they don't typically rent properties at that price. They usually buy them. So from a rental point of view, that's going to definitely be your best opportunity, is that $80,000 to $120,000, $130,000 point. That's the sweet spot to really get your 8, 9, 10% ROI, as well as keeping your property overhead and costs low. Because as you go, again, as you go higher in price, your property taxes are higher, your insurance, your community fees, all of that goes higher with it, in which the rent does not correlate to exactly. One of the things that really also makes us unique opposed to a lot of different real estate branches and brokerages out there is the fact that we're a complete done-for-you company. And what I mean by that is all of the properties that we give as a final product, as a final turnkey investment home, it is fully renovated top to bottom. We've renovated and sold well over a few hundred, and maybe we might be even into the thousands now, investment properties that all have kind of this bread and butter rehab that goes into it, renovation from, you know, paint, carpet, appliances, flooring, you know, interior, exterior, windows, air conditioner if it needs to be replaced, the whole nine yards, so that when a tenant walks into the property, they're blown away and they're going to sign right then and there to lock down that house because it's just the nicest one that they've seen. But in the same token, it's going to greatly reduce any property expense and maintenance that you're going to have in the near future just because it has just gone through an entire renovation schedule. And another great thing about this area as well too is a majority of the homes are block built. So even if the house is built in the 1980s or early 1990s, it doesn't make a dramatic difference even if it was built versus 2000 or 2005 because it is block built. So much like properties overseas in Europe that are either block or brick or some type of concrete built, they last forever. Now, there are a couple of things that obviously will need to be updated, such as the roof and maybe the electrical or plumbing supply, but all of that is taken care of as well as the renovation. So it really gives you a great peace of mind that the property is not only in great condition, but it's not going to give you any headaches in the near future. You know, it's not a perfect world, so maybe in a year, two, three, or 4 years, you're going to have to spend a couple dollars and invest it into the home to make sure it's running properly, because things do happen, as I'm sure you understand, as Walter has seen. You know, unfortunately, that's just, it's just not a perfect world. So yeah, things do break down, but fortunately, we do everything we can to really minimize that, and so you get to maximize your ROI for the first few years without having to worry about it. One of the other things that we also do that we package into our properties is a property management company. We've worked very closely now with Rentals Orlando for many years, and I believe all of Walter's properties in Central Florida are in their portfolio, and they specialize in foreign investors. And so, again, a majority of their clientele, if not, I think all of them, are overseas somewhere, whether it's in England, Ireland, South Africa, China, Singapore, etc. They've really scheduled and geared their business model to catering to investors that are not local and that are around the entire world. So you would receive what's called your Rentals Orlando portal. So it basically looks like the backside of a bank website. You get to see money in, money out, you know, any inquiries that you might have or that a tenant might have. And so it's a very transparent and very organized system that you're able to just get your cash flow in. If you don't have a U.S. bank account already, we'll help organize one for you. And another key thing about that is the fact that all of the properties that you'll have, it's a very simple screenshot, so you get to see all the year-end income. They get to take care of all the taxes for you, so all they do is just send all that information off to the accountant, again, that we'd be able to refer to you for, and they handle everything from A to Z, so it's a completely turnkey situation. They deal with sourcing the tenant, qualifying the tenant, dealing with obviously all of the inquiries that the tenant might have. And they, you know, one of the things that they've really mastered over the course of the past few years and dealing with so many houses is getting the best quality tenant possible in place. You know, so not only do they find the tenant, but they also make sure that they are qualified. They check their credit score, criminal background check, employment verification, and previous landlord referrals. So again, it kind of comes full circle in terms of saying it's not a perfect world. Things do happen. And as well as a tenant might sound on paper, you never know what tomorrow is going to bring. But fortunately, they use every single tool available to ensure that they are, to the best of their knowledge, putting in the highest quality and most qualified tenant into your home that's going to pay rent regularly. And that's the key thing. When it comes to buying the property in the States and in Florida in particularly, it's a little bit different and significantly easier than what it is overseas. So Florida is what's called a title company state. So we don't deal with solicitors or lawyers when it comes to transaction of property because the title companies, they're called, they handle all of that. So they're a neutral third party company that basically says, here's what the contract says from the buyer's point of view. Here's what it says from the seller's point of view. And we're going to go ahead and just make sure that both of them act accordingly and they do what they're supposed to do. And then we'll go ahead and transfer the title or the deed of the property accordingly. So all the money that's involved in the property transaction, such as the deposit, the balance, and everything in between, is all held in a secure escrow account or trust that is federally regulated and managed by the title company through the process of the property transaction. Now, fortunately, when I say it's much easier than what it is overseas, You can literally buy a property in as little as 5 days, sometimes even sooner. And, but we typically say it's going to take anywhere from 21 to 30 days to complete. So from the moment you say, hey, that property looks great, I'm going to go ahead and reserve it until the time that you actually get handed the keys or the management company, it takes about 21 to 30 days. That gives the title company time to do all of their due diligence to make sure that you have 100% freehold clear title with no debts or liens or any previous encumbrances attached to it. But in the same token, a lot of the time investors need to go ahead and move money around when it comes to the balance that's going to be paid for the property itself.
Market, market, market.
And so one of the reasons that Walter has picked Orlando, I'm sure, to be one of his primary investment property areas is because of how well the market's doing. And you probably noticed Jim behind me now. He just came in. So he's one of our acquisition guys that helps find the properties from the asset management company. But going back to Orlando, property prices peaked in 2007 at an average median value of $264,000. And after the GFC and housing crisis in 2008 in America, and even in particularly in Florida, property prices bottomed out and plummeted to an average of $99,000. So from 264 to 99, that's a huge plummet. But fortunately, since then, and due to the fact that inventory is drying up, there's only so many foreclosures on the market. The stock market's back, unemployment is down, and the economy in America overall is just doing much, much better. The average median household price right now in Orlando is back up to $184,000. So it's gone up quite dramatically, but there's still a ways to go. And the good thing about the amount that the prices have rose over the past 4 years is they're rising for the right reason and not the wrong reason that they did in 2005, 6, and 7. And back then, 10, 12 years ago, they were increasing very, very quickly due to the fact that banks were lending irresponsibly to people who didn't deserve them. Buyers and homeowners were refinancing their properties for 150% of what they bought it for. And there was just a lot of cheap money going around that was all on false promises. So when you combine that, as well as obviously what was happening in the stock market and all of the wars and all that stuff, it was a perfect storm. So fortunately, since then, there's been so many regulations, rules, and laws put in place that's going to really prevent that in the future. And so the prices right now have been increasing so dramatically just due to the fact that there aren't as many foreclosures on the market. So for a quick example, if you have a neighborhood of 100 properties and 50 of them are in foreclosure, and it's going to greatly diminish all the values of the 50 that are not in foreclosure. So it's like if you were to walk around a shopping plaza and there's 100 stores and 50 of them are empty, you're going to really think it's a really cheap and dodgy shopping area. However, as those stores get filled, it really increases the value of all of them around them, which is exactly what's happening in the market right now, as well as the fact that banks are lending again responsibly, and home buyers, first-time home buyers, as well as new developers are building again. So that's really, really helping out the market. So Orlando is forecasted to see another 10, 12, 15% increase over the next 24 months. It's really at a healthy 7 to 8% growth per year from a capital appreciation point of view. Nationally, the average is about 4.5%, but Orlando is pretty higher than that just due to the fact of what I just outlined, because there are a lot of states that aren't as unique as Florida when it comes to home values, as well as being the number one tourist destination in the world. Interesting fact is, even when there was the depression going on and the global financial crisis and all that, population and tourism increased in Orlando just because you had so much money pouring in from all different corners of the globe at all times. And that really, really helped out the market. So even during the worst of times, money was still coming in, and it wasn't a dead economy like in Detroit or Buffalo or Texas or something like that. So fortunately, this is a fantastic market to invest in from a property point of view, as well as the fact that you've now found a great company that's going to be able to hold your hand through the entire process, whether it's your first property or 50th. And so I'm super excited that Walter was able to point you in our direction. And if you have any further questions, please shoot them either my way or to Wayne or even to Walter, and we'll all be willing to help you out. And we certainly look forward to getting your portfolio started. Have a great day.